we're going to start by creating text. You're going to press T for text. Then you're going to write graphic designer. We are using the Komorebi font. And then you're going to write graphic design. And then you're going to make this nice and big and large. And you're going to change the color and make it a bright reddish color. Something like that. Let's just reduce the line spacing a little bit. And then next, so you're going to go to your lines and shapes, and then you're going to scroll down to go find the cup-like shape. It is called trapezoid down. So add the trapezoid down, drag it a little bit to make it a little bit longer, and then go to your borders and weights and create a corner rounded kind of a shape for your cup. And we want a nice gradient color for the cup, so we're going to go pick this reddish orangish color, and then you duplicate the shape, reduce it and make it a little bit smaller. And the duplicated shape, we want to add that as a black background, or rather as a black cup, so that we can create the illusion that this is a nice beautiful cup that you've created. So you're going to highlight the two shapes and group them, and then you can just put them on the side for now to carry on with your design. You're going to go back to your elements, and now you want a line. So you could either press L for a line, or you could go find the line on your lines and shape. And we want to create pens, so we're going to add a nice tallish pen, increase the size or the weight of the pen, have a cool color. So let's add a bright pink for the pen, and then go to our lines and shapes and add a, I always get this one wrong, a triangle. I don't know why I always get triangles wrong. Then you move your triangle and reduce the size of it to a small triangle so that it is a pen-like shape. You can always zoom in so that you can work better when you've zoomed in. Reduce it and align it on the pen. And hold on, let's just also change the color to pink and then group them. Duplicate those shapes. Have a green pen. Lovely stuff. Then grab your cup that you've created and add your two pens to your cup. And send them to back so that they're in a cup and they look like that. Your next step is to just add a nice splash on there. So I found this gorgeous splash that goes hand in hand with the color, and it is called Artistic Ink Splash by Ratoka. And then rotate the splash and add it to your design. And send it back so that it's in the cup like that, and then highlight everything, group it, and then rotate it. So I'm gonna grab my splash that I've used over there, and I'm gonna crop some of it out, and I'm gonna use some of this to add on my design. The last thing I would do is to add Tez's initials, which is TS, and I would add that on the cup. So I would use Anton as my font, and in line with the wording, I would add it as a hollow and then change the color and make it a nice bright red as well. Have that as a design. And I'll download this as a 2D. So I'll go to share, select my download to download page one as a transparent background, and then jump in on Photopea to convert it to 3D. If you're comfortable with your 2D and you don't want to convert it to a 3D, then your process stops here. if you want to convert it to 3D, then you need to change the cups inside, the one that we've added that's black, change it back to white so that you can go to remove.bg or erase.bg to take off the that cups inside and make it a transparent. Canva doesn't do that for us anymore, so we use remove.bg. Once you've done that, you can go to remove.bg, edit on there and take off the cups inside as well as the background, and then jump onto Photopea to convert it to a 3D. 3D, you're going to access www.photopea.com. We're going to be using templates, so you're going to select templates. You're always welcome to use your own mockup by using Open from Computer. And then you pick any mockup you want to use. I would like to use this one today. You select it, then you click on the link that says photopea.com and you wait for the mockup to load. After it has loaded, you're going to access where it says your logo here, and you're going to double click on the checkered box, and then it's going to show you an example. You click on the eye to hide the example, and then you go find your downloads that you've just downloaded from remove.bg. Click and you drag it to your canvas, and it's beautifully added there. You size it and you make it nice and big by using the corners, and then you press Command S or Control S to change it to a smart object. Once it's updated, you click back on the first tab to access your design, and there's your gorgeous looking design created on Canva and converted to 3D using Photopea. If you want more videos like this, please smash the like button. Let me know so that I can continue giving you ideas that are like this. You can always go to our playlist and learn more about 3D mockups. All you do to export it, you go File, Export As, depending on the file that you want. We'll go with PNG, and that's it. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.